We could literally map these buttons to whatever we want. We can add harmony. In music, there's just this supernatural, this higher power that you really can't explain in words. Add a bass line. It's something that, you know, I feel when I'm performing and when I'm creating music. Drop it down an octave. For a laptop orchestra, the way I kind of view it is the laptop is the technique, and all of the creativity, all of the musical nuance and expression comes from the human performer still. So it's a blend of art, science, and technology.
It's tracking the relative distance of my eye.
Ito took that into a whole new realm. I asked him to write a piece for face. There's a software program that maps facial gestures to essentially whatever you want.
So this one, it's measuring my blinks, which is where the piano sounds are coming from.
And he's creating this very unique duet piece that makes music out of your face.
So this is the sine wave. For me, it's really important as a composer to adapt to new technology. I mean, the same way that in the 18th and 19th centuries, they were following the sort of development of the piano. It's only now, sort of 100 years later, that we can kind of look back and kind of assess the level of success or drawback to the technology. Computers are the same. It's just another instrument. It's something else to explore.
I think dance provides the opportunity for communication, a way to express yourself, a way to really connect with something deeper. And I love the feeling that I get when I'm on stage performing in front of others.
We're taking the tap shoes and we're trying to take the choreography that the dancer comes up with and then map that to the synthetic sounds.
So when I tap, you know, either my toes or my heels, it could be percussion, it could be rain. We have the yellow jackets doing some vocal cues and sounds that are being mapped to the shoes. So the idea is that I can manipulate any sound that I want with my feet.
There is no typical student at Rochester, because a typical student is so diverse. Because here you don't have students that just major in biomedical engineering. They're also in an a cappella group. They're also a ballet dancer, or, you know, they're president of five different clubs at the same time.
In some ways, we come from different worlds, like the engineering, electronic, musical world, and then the dancing world. And I think that sometimes things get lost in translation. So we've both learned a lot of valuable communication skills.
I mean, music is a very personal thing to a lot of people, and we were moved by it in different ways. I hope that it just gets people thinking about, you know, how technology and music might interact, or other disciplines might be able to interact with music.
A production of the University of Rochester. Please visit us online and subscribe to our channel for more videos.